If we integrate function from C to C, we will integrate along a curve in C. How are we going to describe those curves? And can we use any curves? In this video, you will learn some basic properties of those curves, which we will need later on for our integration. Talk about arcs in the complex plane. Set of points, z equals x, y, is called an arc if the functions x of t and y of t are continuous functions of t, where t is a real parameter varying between a and b. So we want continuous functions, so an arc without sudden jumps. The arc c is said to be described by z as a function of t. Now we can have some basic properties. An arc c is called simple if it doesn't intersect itself, like that. Except maybe at the start and end point. So formulas, z of t1 is not equal to z for t2 as long as you are between a and b with your t1 and t2, and if they are not equal, of course. The curve is called closed if you are at the same point at start and end point, so z at a equals z at b. And finally, positive orientation is a counterclockwise orientation. So let's take a look at some examples. Over here, this curve is not an arc because we jump from here to there. Not describing a continuous function. Second picture is an arc, which is simple, doesn't intersect itself, but not closed. Begin and end point are not the same. Then, over here, the arc is closed. Start and end point are the same, but we are intersecting ourselves over here. So it's a closed arc, but not a simple one. And finally here, we have an example of an arc which is both simple and closed.